Station would say, relax and leave the driving to us. So God is saying, I got this. Just rest. Just take a breather. And so many times God will do things and we really don't catch on to it when he's telling us to rest. Sometimes he'll do it, believe it or not, he'll do it through a sickness. He will do it through a trial. He'll do it by allowing you to lose your job. He will do it by allowing something to happen in your life where you have to hit the pause button and say, oh, wait a minute.
Please.
All right. I'm going to take a rest. And he wants you to rest. Then number two, he will give you information during the rest. Really? Yes. He'll give you information. In other words, he will talk to you. Really, Pastor? Yes, he'll talk to you. He will talk to you and say, listen, this is what I want you to do. Listen, this is what I don't want you to do. This is what I need for you to do to take care of certain things. I've even had times where God will give me information about certain things, and I know it comes from God because there's no way in the world I can thank God for that. Let me give you an example. Even the little things. I thank God for the big things and the little things. A few months ago, I went to the drugstore, to the store, and I went and normally, you know, since the slack, she'll buy my toiletries and everything, but this day, I just happened to be walking through and I saw a different kind of deodorant, Arm & Hammer. I said, you know what? It was on sale. I said, I'm going to get that. So I got me a big old bottle of Arm & Hammer, and I'm using that. And about a month later, all of a sudden, I got pains. Like in the side of my chest, just pain. And I'm waking up, I'm like, what in the world? And it's so sensitive. And I'm like, what in the world? And I'm thinking to myself, I have to go to the doctor because something must be wrong here. And, you know, maybe I got moles or something like that. I'm just thinking. And I laid down and went to sleep. And when I woke up that next morning, as soon as I woke up, I know it was God. He said, it's your deodorant. He said, change back to Sure. I said, really? He said, change back to Sure. I said, okay. And I went to the store, got me some Sure, started using it. A couple days later, everything was fine. And don't you know if he did it for me, he can do it for y'all too? He let me know. And I said, thank you. I said, because there's no way in the world I would have thought of that. There's no way in the world. I just asked him. He said, it's your deodorant. Change your deodorant. Change it back. I said, okay, God, thank you. And I changed it back. Haven't had a problem since. But that's the information that he can give you. He can give you information about yourself, about your body, about your mind, about other people. He can give you the information that you need in order to go forward. So he can talk to you and give you information. Just kind of like how you have a sporting event, a football game or a basketball game, where you have halftime where the coach will come in and he'll say, listen, this is what they did and this is what we saw. And these are the adjustments that we're going to make on the defense and the adjustments we're going to make on the offense. And then we're going to go back to the second half because now we have the information on how they are going to play. So he'll give you information. He'll give you information, like I said, about yourself, about your family. He gave me information about somebody that this past week, and he told me, he said, nobody around here, but something else. He said, call so-and-so. I said, huh? He said, call so-and-so. I said, God, I don't feel like calling them. He said, call them. So I'm sitting in the office. He said, call them. I'm like, okay, all right, I'll call them. And Then, you know, I'm doing it begrudgingly. I said, I'm going to call him. I'm going to call him down to the number. I said, God, they're probably not even going to answer. They answered on the second ring. And it turns out that the person was much sicker than what I thought. And they really did not know who I was. And a relative of theirs had to tell them, that's Pastor Slack. You know him? Going on and on and on. And the more I talked, then it came to them who I was. And I said, wow, God, I did not know they were doing that bad off. And God said, that's why I told you to call. I said, okay, God, I'm sorry. I am sorry. I said, well, at least I got it up off of me. And at least I called. At least I did what you told me. So he gave you the information. But you have to do it during a time of rest. Because when you're busy in the hustle and bustle of life and when you're doing different things, when he tries to talk to you, you'll miss it. But when you are resting and still, that's when he can give you the information that you need. Just like they say when you're dealing with children, with small children, the best time to talk to children to find out what's going on with them is the time right before they get ready to go to bed, when they're relaxing. And you say, okay, how'd your day go? And that's the time they'll tell you everything that you need to know. And that's the time where you can pour into them everything that you want them to know. And then they'll sleep on it, and that's in their mind. It's the best time to talk to children. Right from where they're bed. Rest. God says, I will give you rest, and I'll give you information. And not only will I give you information, then I'll give you revelation. The revelation is, this is the purpose of what this is about. This is what everything is really about. See, we look at things from day to day, but God sees things big picture. God says that I knew you before you were in your mother's womb. I had a plan for you. I know the thoughts that I have towards you. They are thoughts of good and not of evil to bring you to an expected end. You may be going through this, but this is just a season. It's not always going to be like this. This is just a season. The seasons change. Just as summer goes to fall, the fall goes to winter, and winter goes to spring. Seasons change. So, what I'm doing is taking you through this is to prepare and equip you for the next season. I went and looked in the store right after Christmas. Sister Slack and I went, and she, you know, I followed her. She took me to the store shopping. And so when I went in, I looked. In this one store, all the Christmas stuff was taken down. I said, wow. They did this quick. All the Christmas stuff was taken down. A lot of the winter stuff was gone. They putting out spring stuff. I said, wait a minute, this is not even the 1st of January. And they are already putting out spring stuff, preparing for the next season. And God said, what do you see? I said, I see spring. He said, they're preparing for the next season. That's what I do when I give you the information. It's in preparation for the next season. You may be going through this, seemingly wondering what is going on. It seemingly is not adding up. It's not amounting to much. But no, this is preparation for the next season. That's the revelation. So in rest, information, revelation, and last but not least, refreshing. He will refresh you during the time that he is restoring your soul. He will refresh you. He will bring new strength into you. He will allow your mind to go back to how it used to be. You won't have that fear or dread or that I can't take it anymore. You will be able to exhale fully. You'll be able to dream again. You'll be able to say, okay, let's do it. I'm ready.